there's a lot more to building a good Node-RED flow than just placing and wiring nodes. It's important to regularly back up your flows, make the most of Node-RED features, and thoroughly debug your programs. These things will help keep your applications as understandable and maintainable as possible. If you establish these good habits early on, they'll be second nature when you start working on more complex projects. In this workshop, I will show you some tools, techniques, and features that make Node-RED better to work with and easier to maintain. A very important maintenance feature of Node-RED is the ability to import and export flows. Not only is this a great way to share your programs through simple text format, but also a very convenient way to back up flows in case anything happens to your system or you want to wind back to an earlier version of your project. I'll go into Node-RED and show you how to back up your flows now. In Node-RED, highlight the nodes you want to export. Come over to the menu in the top right corner. Hover over Export and select Clipboard. If you want to export only the highlighted nodes, you can leave it on Selected Nodes and click Export to Clipboard. Now, when I go back to the menu, hover over Import, select Clipboard, paste my text in the window, and when I select Current Flow and push Import, I can place them anywhere on the screen. Left click to anchor them, and they're now in the flow. If instead I wanted to bring these into their own flow, under Import Clipboard, I can choose New Flow, paste my text in the window, and when I select Import, it'll bring it open into a new flow where I can place them here instead. If you want to export an entire flow and not just highlighted nodes, you'll notice that the export button is grayed out until you actually do highlight some nodes. Now that I've highlighted the nodes, I can select Export Clipboard and choose to export the current flow. Now when I choose Export to Clipboard and import the flow, I'll find that it opens it in a new window with the same name, even though I chose to import it in the current flow. This is because I imported an entire flow page and not just the node formation. Highlight the nodes you want to export. Come over to the menu in the top right corner, hover over Export and select Clipboard. Importing and exporting all flows essentially does the same thing, but instead, it grabs every single page and imports them all at once. To move nodes between flows, select them and use either Ctrl-C to copy or Ctrl-X to cut, move to your next flow, use Ctrl-V to paste, and then left-click to anchor them. If you want to make a new flow without importing a new page, you can use this plus icon in the top right. To delete a flow, double-click the title and use the delete key in the top left. I'll delete a few of the flows I've made now. From that same screen, you can see that you can rename your flow and give it a brief description. Here you could include things like flow functionality or simply who the author of it is. Now when I click Done, I'll see this information appear on the right-hand side. As well as documenting in this information window, you can also go over to the Function Nodes section and grab a comment node. Even though Node-RED is a visual programming tool, comments are necessary to clarify how the flow works, especially when you're sharing the project or have multiple people working on it. When you drag that in and edit it, you can set some text in the title of the node and go into further detail in the body. This text body supports GitHub flavored Markdown, which you can find out more about using this link here. Another way to help keep things clear is by being mindful of how you wire flows. If I want to connect this input node to this debug node, for example, having the wire go under this function node is confusing because it looks wired in, but it's actually not. If I want, I can place it in the flow by dragging it over the wire, watch it go dashed, and release. Now it is wired into the flow. It's also unclear when nodes have the wiring cross over each other, like in this example here. When nodes get all squished up like this, you can make the wiring a lot clearer just by spreading things out a little. Also, when having nodes stacked like this, or just in general, you may want to go into the settings and click Snap to Grid. This will make the nodes align themselves automatically and easily. Just that makes this flow look a lot more consistent and clear. In this settings window, you can also choose to show the grid on the screen and change the grid size. Also in this settings window, you can see the keyboard shortcuts. This can also help improve your efficiency in Node-RED, because along with cut, copy, paste, delete, and undo, you can customize a lot of different Node-RED commands to make your programming a lot more efficient. Another useful Node-RED feature is the built-in libraries. Just highlight the nodes that you wish to save, go over to Export, and right below Clipboard, there's an option to save things to a library. You can have an organized file system using the forward slash, and give it a file name, like email. Now when I export this flow, it gets saved, and I can bring it into any other flow by coming into Import, Library, navigating through my organized structure, and grabbing the email flow. Now I can place this on any page I'd like without the overhead of having to use a text document. The other library function in Node-RED is for function nodes. Here I have a simple function that splits the payload at the space character. When I deploy and inject on this flow, it'll split the string "this is a test" into four separate messages "this is a test." If I want to reuse this code, I can go into the function node and use this book icon to save it to my library. Again, I have the option to use an organized folder structure, and I can give it a descriptive file name. Now when I save this to the library, I can bring in another function node, go to the book icon again, select Open Library, go through my folder structure, and open this code and load it straight into this node. Now when I deploy, come down and inject the flow, you'll see it split "Hello World" into the two messages "Hello World." It's important to note, though, that if I come down to the original node and change the split character to be S, click Done, and deploy, when I deploy and inject on this bottom flow, I'll find that "this is a test" is broken up with each string ending in S. But when I inject on "Hello World," it's still splitting at the space character, since this node is completely unchanged. If you do want to have node functionality change in multiple places that you're using it, all from the one source, you should use subflows. Here, I'll select this one function node, go into the menu, hover over subflows, and click Selection to Subflow. Now I'll replace both of my function nodes with this subflow. Now when I deploy and inject both messages, they should split at the space character, which they do. If I go into the subflow by double-clicking it and selecting Edit Flow Template, I can change the functionality of the node here to split at the character O. Also from this screen, I can rename the subflow to be a little bit more descriptive. I can even give it a description in the field below. Now when I come back to my original flow, deploy the changes, and inject on both nodes, I'll see that the first string is split at each of the O's, and the second string is not split at all since it does not have an O character in it. The functionality has changed in both places just from the one change. These special Subflow nodes will appear in your node palette just like any other node, and you can bring them in as many places as you would like. While we're here, another special node to go over is the catch node. This node just catches any error message that appears in the debug window and triggers this node to inject. You can build up a flow to handle whatever error comes in. I advise that you select specific nodes for it to catch so that it only responds to errors that you have designed the flow to handle. Since the use of this node will be very specific to the type of errors that you're dealing with, it's a bit hard to show examples, so just be aware that it exists and try to put it into use where relevant. Oftentimes, there is more to a message than just the message.payload I've been seeing in the debug window. For example, I'll bring in this email node and quickly set it up. This will pull in messages from my inbox. If I bring in a default debug node and wire that into the email node, click deploy, I'll see that when it fetches an email, all I get is the email text body. If, however, I come in and edit the debug node to display the complete message object, hit done, and deploy, and inject, I can see that there is a message.topic holding the subject, message.date holding the date, message.header showing all sorts of other information. I can copy property text and the path to the property using these debug buttons here. If you make use of catch nodes, subflows, Node-RED libraries, and keyboard shortcuts where appropriate, and always back up your flows, you will find Node-RED to be a reliable and efficient tool for prototyping and developing your various IoT applications. Thanks for watching.